All right, she's so nice and so smart and so beautiful. You think she has everything going her way.
Yes.
But Courtney Thorne-Smith, like me too, traumatized by what's happening at Sunset in the 405.
You two should carpool.
You really should.
I know, we're trying to figure out how we're going to drive home.
Helicopter.
And I'm like, if we get a bike, that'll work.
Nice little bicycle built for two.
All right, so on Two and a Half Men, very funny. We're going to look at some of the stuff in a second. Is that bed comfortable, and is it comfortable smooching John Cryer?
Here's the issue, which is that my husband was in the audience that night, and I warned him that I was going to wear lingerie. I said, lingerie. And I was literally walking out to get into bed with John, and I was like, I forgot to tell him about the making out. Completely forgot my first line. We had it. I'm just thinking, didn't tell him. John says his line, and I'm like, I don't, didn't tell my husband. That's all I could say. I was terrified.
So you're like, hey, by the way,
now,
honey, we're making out. He figured it out.
You're a happily married woman.
I am.
But when you're looking at the script, was there any sort of Charlie Sheen, make it a John Crowley. Was there any why, which one, or would you? would you have a preference?
Like they gave it to me and they said, "Who would you like to make out with?" Is that your idea of how it works in TV?
That's my idea.
Yeah, exactly. No, we read the script together, and the thing about reading Two and a Half Men is they get to do so much. Like, and according to Jim, we joke about these sort of lines that they wouldn't it be funny if we could say. Yeah. And Two and a Half Men, you're saying it.
No, I mean, you
can't believe it. It's so raunchy.
I've always thought that. I think it's successful and it's funny, but it's a dirty
super
show.
You can't believe what you get to say. It's like, we can't really say that. And Chuck's like, we're fighting for it. Chuck Lorre, who creates the show. Yeah. We're fighting. I'm like, all right, good luck with it.
We're going to take a look. But you're, quote unquote, a hot mom.
Why are you putting that in quotes?
Why can't I delete that?
My vision's as good as anybody else. I don't even put it in quotes. Here, a little clippy from the show.
Do we have anything to eat?
Order a pizza. I've got company.
Is it Dave?
No.
Jimmy?
No. He's just trying to push my buttons.
Yeah, Jake's exactly the same way. Always trying to get my goat. Now, who are Dave and Jimmy?
Please don't tell me you're doing Jake's loser dad.
I'm a divorced mother with a 16-year-old son. I can't be picky. Funny.
Well, there you are.
That's rough.
Killed the mood.
I know. Poor Alan.
I know.
But people always talk about this. And obviously it's been on for a while, that it's a very, like, professional environment. They really knock it out.
Oh, absolutely. Well, you know, they've been doing it so long, and they're both such pros. I've known John for a long time. I've wanted to work with him forever, so it was really fun. And Charlie was so sweet. It's great. You know, they say, this is when you get there, this is when run-throughs, this is when you're home, and it's like a clock. It's great.
And you've done a ton of this, according to Jim, and then, of course, all the other shows. Is it a different shop, or does it all eventually, you know, just different people,
it's,
same
you know,
shop?
It's different to walk in to a show that's been around so long, and you're new. You know, it's like being on the first day of school. You know, I'm really shy, and it's hard to get used to it. But by the second one, I felt like I'd found my sea legs. And everybody's so sweet. They love being there. It's great.
Yeah. Well, there we go. We will watch Courtney Thorne-Smith tonight, the brand new Two and a Half Men on CBS at 9. And come back, we'll talk about Atkins and all sorts of stuff.
Excellent.
Very, very good.
We have some breaking news. Let's get to Frank Buckley across the way. Frank.